younger pups, one of the first things they tell them in spring is spacing is an offense. Spacing is an offense. They've got to learn that these are the spots we'd like them to be at. Okay, I'm going to have these spots. I have to go on the other end here by a second or something, but they got to know these are spots. I would not put the spots here for the varsity girls. Your girls, yeah, getting close to the three-point line. Okay, you got a crew that can run a lot faster. Well, varsity girls, we'll move those spots 3 or 4 feet behind those lines because we should be out that deep. So we give people cut through the lane or anybody posting up in 41 a lot more room. Okay, so layer one, which most of those kids already know. Pass and cut. Okay, offense. Do it at game speed and do the things that you've been taught to do in 50 passes cut. Alright? No skip passes right now. Right? Play. Full speed. 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 Keep going. Keep going. Cut hard. Cut hard. You gotta cut hard, Benjamin. Cut hard. Explode the round. Explode the round. Explode the round. Look at your cutters. Look at everybody on the team. Look at everybody on the team. And stop and load. Stop and load. Stop and load. Hey, okay, I mean, there's a couple girls that understand it can't be the same speed when you cut to the basket. It has to be an all-out explosion to beat that girl in the basket. Okay? Girls that move at one speed, well, no offense works for them. They've got to learn to slow. Now, these guys know I'm controlling the weightlifting this year during the season because that's one of the biggest areas where you're going to get more explosive, okay? Some of these guys have been working with that guy over there, Nick Lewis, and I mean, you can tell there's a little more explosion with some of these kids, right? We're all going to get it, okay? But you can tell right now who's been working at that stuff and who hasn't, okay? You guys move very well. Now, here's the next thing I want. Do the same offense, fast and cut, but mix in a skip pass here and there, okay? So that you guys can see, if I skip it, I'm not the cutter. It's whoever's closest to the ball that's gonna cut to the basket. So if they skip it, two girls, one girl, whatever, okay, they are not the cutter, right? Play, come on, explosive to the rim. There you go, explosive to the rim. Explosive to that ass, explosive to that ass. Explosive to that ass. Mix in a skip. Okay, here we go. There you go. And that's how it becomes like a different offense. Mix and skip pass. There you go. Nice. Yeah. There you go. Keep all the balls with your cutters. There you go. That way it floats out. Come on. There you go. Come on. Get that X. Get that X. Get that X. Going hard. Okay. There you go. All right. Stop. Reload it. Stop if you want to come in. Come in. Stop if you want to come in. And the first thing I like to impress upon you guys is this is an offense. This is the whole offense. There were some springs where this is all I did. Teams that wanted to play man-to-man that I knew were not very good at the positioning. If you can get kids, especially with the skip passes. I know they're young pups and some may not be strong enough to do it. But when they are, that adds a whole new dimension to the offense. Okay? Now, challenge you guys right away. Challenge you guys right away. And I want you to think about it. I realize this may not work if you're trying to rotate while you're doing it. Okay, but there are times when, all right, everybody's at the spot. If I were to throw it, Maddie, two girls can cut. There's two girls are next to the ball. You come out this way, you go out that way. Okay? Right? So anytime the ball goes to the top, okay, or if you face something, she would have skipped over to a wing, skip it to a wing, two girls can cut. Bonzo's going in and out, and it's going in and through. Just like you normally do it. Alright, so that's your challenge. Max has got to try to get skips from the bottom to a opposite wing, or from the bottom to the top. Alright, play. Play, play, play. That's not hard. Put that X, put your feet on that X in the wing. And put an X on the corner because that's what I need him to get. Otherwise, it'll make your pass too short. Cut. You're rotating too hard, you do the two. Here we go. Skip that to the top sometimes. Two cutters, there it is. There you go, two cutters. There you go. There you go. There you go. Look the ball, look the ball. Come on. Look the Ball back in the bottom. That ball goes to the top. But wings are cut through and coming out the same side of the game ball. That's going to be the open spot. Not a mistake. I always tell the younger folks, it's not a mistake unless you make it look like a mistake. So although I'd rather than that cross right now, I'm not saying they couldn't in the game. Okay, but right now, for the sake of showing you guys, it's not a mistake if you don't make it look like one. You got kids to go. I love playing those kids. I know what they're doing. Okay? All right. Continue the challenge. Go. What? Pass the hard top. Do it again. Keep rope that ball on top. Rob, what was your paper about in advance writing today? Shocking kids using freaking tasers. We wrote a satire on how to motivate kids. How to solve student apathy. They always use tasers. Which, yeah, they're dumb enough to ask me, but I'd be willing to use it. Okay? So, listen. Literally, you cut like you just got tased by 54,000 volts. 50,000 volts. That's how you should cut. Because most girl defenders don't want to play defense. They don't. They want to relax. My girl passed it on. If you got to do it, goes right away. That's why I like this offense. You got five girls that can freaking move. That sucks for a man-to-man defense. Sucks for them. Somebody's going to get open. Yeah, here we go. Play. Step the jam. Come on, you got tape. You got tape! Come on, skip it. Give me that baseline, skip stuff. Get to the baseline sometimes. Alright, get to our baseline so we can make that double skip. Make that top throw of the wing. Top throw of the wing. Two cutters, two buns. There you go, nice. There you go. Okay, stop. And the other five girls again. I went 41, Lily, a lot of the spring. You notice the spots after you drop. That's why you have a blue forward and a black five. Those always go on the wing. Okay? Because in 41, your spots have to adjust. It's not a mistake to have it go down here. It's not a mistake. Okay, but really we try to keep those spots because I'm calling 41 during games anytime I see somebody dumb enough to play one-on-one on that girl. And I do need dumb enough. It's stupid to play her one-on-one. I'm very rigid in the second. To be a second. Okay? Alright? I mean, it's just, no. And I have as much confidence in that girl as I do other girls this year. If you're going to be crazy enough to let Maddie Janish make a pass from the wing or from the top and then post up one-on-one, I expect Maddie to score a lot of points this year. I want them to have to double team her. Have to double team three or four. Bayless Steinkamp. I want them to have to double team her. Right now, the girls on the perimeter are passing and cutting, but about every other pass has to go to the post. Put on the 50%. So, if Katie's on the low block for a number of months, if she calls the ball and passes her, you always create space with your cut. So if the pass is to her by low post by low post, she cuts over the elbow, everybody rotates like they normally do. Except now your spots are lane lines and wings. Not the top, no point guard. Okay? Same deal, spacing is an offense. Okay? Spacing is an offense. You have to train these kids to understand lane lines, you gotta care. Give the basketball. If she goes to the high post and catches the pass, get back to the wing, comes from the wing, she cuts low. If for some reason Katie's in the middle of the lane, she's in the middle, you got your choice. You go high and go low, it doesn't matter to you. Okay, the whole premise is create space. Okay? Again, use Lily at the high post a lot this spring because every time we passed her, we had two girls that were cutting. One of them was open every stinking time going to the basket. So you got to have your post in this drill, move around, work on posting up in different spots depending on where the ball is. Okay, so the ball comes from the high post, or to the high post. She's just got to create space and cut. You guys rotate off, rotate the opening spot, opening spot, opening spot, okay? All right? So don't give me any skip pass or anything like that. Just about every other pass, every third pass, get it to Saul. She's going to call for the ball. She doesn't get it. Pass it to her, make the appropriate cut and rotate. Ready? Play. Full speed. Okay. 41. Yeah. Close pass. Stop. Start it again. It's been a while. A lot of open jumps. Okay, but you're coming out to the open wing spot in 41. Right? Not a mistake if you go to the baseline. But you got to immediately see that that spot above you is open and fill it. Okay, play.
Okay.
Open wing spot. Open wing spot. Here you go. Okay, you got a good look. Get a good look. Here you go. Pass it back out. Keep moving it. Close pass. Cut. First and foremost, if that girl can make any post move whatsoever, fear the ball and let her score. I mean, that's her first job. Katie, she knows I get mad. I got mad at Claire, I got mad at Mick Stumbling, I got mad at a lot of girls over the year because I'm like, really? You just caught the ball in the post one-on-one and you didn't make a move? I'm not asking you right now. Okay, but that's job one. You got a girl that can make any one of those three post moves that we'll show you here in a second. Well, train her. Spend some time with her off on the side in your driveway or whatever. Okay, and teach her drop step, you know, the three moves that I put on the list. Okay, some of those girls probably have other moves because I know they're training with Nick too. Okay, but get that through their skulls first. When you play it for real, we feed you the ball and you got one-on-one. You ain't passing the ball out. Your teammates should tell you, you got it, one-on-one. Bust the move. The girl should still cut because your girl might go help on that girl if she scores enough. Okay, so right now, don't look to score. Keep moving around, mix it and skip pass. Once in a while, mix it and skip. Here we go, play. 41, Slayer 2. Close pass and cut. Close pass and cut. Hopefully you guys are already thinking maybe we could break this down into a three-person drill or a two-person drill. Put a post up. Pass her out there. Work on the cuts after passing into the post. Okay. We're going to be 3 or 4 feet outside that three-point line. Unless you're in the game where somebody that can actually spot and shoot. But we're trying to get her space. When you guys rotate, stay way above those dots. Stay above those dots. 42 feet of court. Play. You move. Every other pass, get in there. Every other pass. Stop. There you go. Get in space. There you go. You work on your passes as opposed to. Here we go. All right. Stop. Reload it. Okay. Now.